Hey devs, how are you? Welcome to another video from WebStylePress. If this is your first time here, we share tutorials at this channel. If this interests you, join this channel by hitting subscribe button and bell icon. There are quite a lot web hosts that offer free web hosting service that supports PHP databases and WordPress. You can create your own website free of charge and host it there for as long as you desire. In this video, we are looking at few web hosting services that offer such facility. Let's dive into it. First service that comes into my mind is 000webhost.com. They offer free web hosting at zero cost with PHP, MySQL, cPanel, and they say that no ads, but they may show ads, as I will show you in few minutes. And here you can see the plans. You can see free web hosting at $0 per month. It will give you one website with 300 MB disk space and limited bandwidth of 3 GB, and there will be no email account and there will be no support. So no support is alright, but there's no email account, and bandwidth and disk space is very much limited. You cannot do any serious work by using this. But when you create account with the 000webhost.com, you will see this kind of interface, and you can select from few options from this screen, and you can build an online store, you can create web design, you can start a blog, and then at the next screen you can select from few categories, and then at the next screen they ask you to choose a password. I was stuck at this screen for many minutes, but eventually I moved ahead, and then they ask you to choose what you want to do next. You can use their website builder, you can install WordPress at it straight away, or you can upload your own website. Then you will have this screen presenting you your website here. You can manage your website from here, or you can upgrade your account. And this is their control panel. You can open their file manager from here or install WordPress at this web hosting from here. And as you can see, this is their file manager that can be used directly to upload files or manage your files. And this is a sample website that they created for me. And as you can see, there is an ad at the bottom of the website, powered by 000webhost. So there is an ad. It is ad supported web hosting. So anyways, this is an option that can be used to power your PHP based website. You can upload your own website, or you can install WordPress based website at 000webhost.com and test things out. 000webhost is not new, and I have used it couple of times, and you can use it for staging or dev environments, and it's been around for quite a long time, so you can test this website out. It offers free web hosting without email account and with less resources. The second option that comes into my mind is Infinity Free. Infinityfree.net. free unlimited website web hosting. Unlimited web hosting. This is a quite a big claim. Completely free website hosting with unlimited disk space and bandwidth. Free unlimited website hosting for over 8 years. They say that it's fastest web hosting, 99% uptime, guarantee unlimited hosting, and host any domain. No forced ads, completely free. And they have got soft AQLS as well. When WordPress is supported, they will give you the cPanel. And let's see. And then I created an account at this website, and I got this dummy website after I created account at this service. This is the demo page that they install for a newly created website. And this is my control panel. As you can see, there are details for domain and IP address is not available. MySQL username is here. MySQL password is here. And also host name is there. And they have got the file manager control panel. And this is their file manager that you can use to manage your files. And this is the control panel that they provide. It is not complete control cPanel. It lacks some services, but it has got essential stuff that you can use to manage your website. It has got file manager, directory privacy, FTP accounts, and it has got PHP myadmin, MySQL databases, and then add-on domains, email accounts. But email, I don't think that they support the email in the free account. And they've got, they support Cloudflare, Soft AQLS, Cron Jobs. And from the right side, if we look at the details of the web hosting, they allow subdomains, unlimited subdomains, unlimited add-on domains, unlimited parked domains, MySQL databases are unlimited, disk quota is unlimited, disk space is unlimited, and then bandwidth is also unlimited. Well, this is quite a lot, and main domain is this one. They have given me a subdomain, a domain with prefix, and then FTP host name is here, FTP username is here, MySQL host name is here, MySQL username and hosting volume is here. And then FTP settings is here. I have got an FTP account here, but I cannot create more FTP accounts at this service. That is restricted. And this is the MySQL databases area. I can create databases here, and unlimited databases are allowed here. And for the email accounts, they don't allow the email accounts at the for the free service they offer. Email on free hosting has been depreciated. Upgrade to paid plan to get SMTP, POP, IMAP, and PHP send mail. So email is not provided with this free service. And also PHP selector, PHP version, PHP 7.3 is supported max. And then domains, they have got these name, servers, records, and then my domain. My website is this one with a dummy address, and I can choose a domain from here. I can get a domain from them, and I can attach that domain with this hosting account. So this is also an option that offers proper cPanel, FTP account and file manager, and you will have databases, and it has got unlimited subdomains. You can create multiple websites with multiple subdomains, multiple databases, and you have, and they don't restrict you for space and bandwidth or databases. They restrict you from creating email account. So if you do not need email account, they offer a lot of stuff for free. So infinityfree.net. And then we have got another service, that is Pantheon. Pantheon has been around for a long time, and I have seen software houses using this service for staging and development environment. And if you create account with Pantheon, they have got several plans, but you can create a free plan with them. And there is a problem: if you won't use your site often, your site will be frozen. So that's one drawback. And then you can log in with you can connect with Google, or you can use your email to create an account with them. This was a website that was frozen, and then if your website is frozen, you can unfreeze the site by coming to dashboard, and then this is the dashboard, and here you can see your website. There's a restriction on the number of websites that you can create under one account, but you can create more than one. So PHP supported, WordPress is supported, and your code will have to be at the GitHub, and from there you can pull your code inside Pantheon to host your code here. And this is the WordPress that I hosted with them, and you can have plugins, you can install themes, and well, full WordPress experience can be enjoyed with Pantheon. But as you can see, that this is the plugin area, and when I want to update them all, it asks me for the host name, FTP username and FTP password. They provide the FTP, and you can have the FTP with them, and you will have to use that FTP here to upgrade or install plugins from here. And they won't allow you to edit your theme files directly from WordPress editor. The button is not allowed here, the update button. So you will have to download these files, or you will have to make the changes in your GitHub, and then you will pull the code again to make the changes effective here. So this is a restriction at this website. And finally, this is the page that I was able to create by using Pantheon, and WooCommerce is also installed at this hosting, and you will get the website address like your store name .pantheonsite.io. So this is also a choice, Pantheon. And then there was 000 web host, and then there is infinity free. So there are advantages and disadvantages to use such services. Well, advantages are, these are absolutely free and disposable, and they can prove good to test your work. you can create demo websites as much as you like without paying anything. You can showcase your personal website. You can place website demos for clients to showcase your work progress, but it may not create a good impression. And they can prove useful for staging and development environments to test things out. And as for disadvantages, and they may not provide email hosting, and they may force you to use email address from reputable services like Gmail, Outlook, instead of your domain email address to sign up. And they can freeze your account on inactivity. They can remove your website on inactivity in some cases. And they can restrict you to edit files from WordPress file editor, and you will have to update them manually via FTP. And these services may show advertisement, and they can restrict you to use subdomain, or you will have to buy domain from them. And it's not professional to use ad supported restricted free services. These do not create good impression for sure. So what do you think? Which is your favorite service to host free websites? Now these websites like 000 webhost and Pantheon, these are not new, and these have been around, and I have seen developers using these services, and you can use them safely. And for client, probably Pantheon may prove to be a good choice, and you can also give it a go to this this service inventory. And let me add one thing to this video, that this video is not sponsored by these services. I have used these services, and I am just sharing my experience. So let me know your thoughts in comments, and I hope you liked this video. If I missed anything or you have something to add, comment it down below. Ask questions related to this topic. If you haven't already subscribed, subscribe to the channel and hit bell icon to receive updates. Join us on social media. Links are in the description below. Stay tuned for more updates. I will see you in the next video.